Today we are discussing about the new topic is rectifier. So we can first talk about the rectifier. What is rectifier? We can say that rectifier is a device which will convert the alternating components into DC components. Second thing you can say that it will be gives the unidirectional currents. So rectifiers mostly we are using the PN junction diode as a rectifiers, and some types of rectifiers are also like a silicon rectifiers, mercury vapor rectifiers, metal rectifiers, but most of cases we are using as a our PN junction diode rectifiers because of their are the easy way, because we require is their unidirections. So in the diode we have only two poles, two terminals, one is anode and one is cathode. So it will be easy to connecting with the battery or cell. Then it will be easily when we are applying the input voltages, then easily it will be understand, or easily we can say that when it will comes in the forward directions or when it will comes in the reverse directions. For that purpose, so most of cases we are using the PN junction diodes as a rectifiers. So there are three types of rectifiers. We can, first one is a half wave rectifier, second one full wave rectifier, and third one bridge rectifier. There are three types of rectifiers. The first one we are going to discuss about the half wave rectifier. So as we know that we can go to circuit diagram and we see here we are taking one step down transformer. And here connected with diode. Here we are connecting the load resistance. So here as a transformer, 230 volt 50 hertz frequency, and input as a 230 volt we are applying, but it is the step down transformer, so it will reduces the voltages, and according to maybe it will take 9 volt or 12 volts we have to take as a input voltage. So here we are applying as a input voltage. Then this is positive, this is negative. Here load resistance, according to about this load we can get the output voltage. So when we are passing the voltages, the current direction is this direction. This is the current direction. So here we are applying the sinusoidal voltages. So suppose we are as a in the waveforms, input and output waveforms, we can here see, suppose we are applying input voltages as a sinusoidal, so sinusoidal voltages are applying. So here this is the 0, this is pi, this is 2 pi. Suppose we are taking, this is called as maximum voltage, peak voltages or maximum voltage. So suppose like a 5 volt. So 5 volt up and 5 volt down, minus 5. So when we are applying the positive half cycle, in that case what we are observing, that this is the positive terminal and our cycle is also positive. It means both are positive. So it will work as a forward bias. So when it will work as a forward bias, in that case, here the voltage drop across the diode is 0. So all the voltages, like a 5 volt or 9 volt, how much we are applying here in input, that all the voltages reach at the load terminal. That means we can say that RL value across the RL, output voltage is equal to input voltage, maximum input voltage, how much we are applying. So we can say that when we are taking the output voltages, so here output voltage is as it is. As it is, we are getting. So from 0 to pi, we got same voltage as a output. Next, we are applying the negative half cycle. So during the negative half cycle, this is the positive terminal, but here voltage is negative. So positive and negative connection. So this means it is work as a reverse bias. So if it is reverse bias, then it is work as a open loop. So no open loop means there is no connection between input and load. So all the voltages we are applying, that voltages will not reach at the load, and then finally we can say that the output voltage is changed from pi to 2 pi, we get zero value. So this is the working of the half-wave rectifiers. Similarly, when we can talk about full-wave rectifier, so here we are taking as a center tap transformer. So here we are taking two diodes. One diode is here and another diode is here. Both diode is connected. So this is D1, positive, negative. Positive, negative, this is D2, and now here this is the load current, so across this load across this load resistance we get the output voltage. So now here what we are observing, that the diode D1 gives the I1 current and diode D2 gives the I2 current, then this both will come here and it will give the final current is I1. So now here in that case we can say that full wave rectifier consists of center tap transformer, two diodes and load resistance. We have to find the our output voltages, or we can say that we can find the output current across the load only. So now in that case, what we are observing, here we are considered in terms of current, because of it will be suitable for current. So now, first we are applying the positive half cycle. In the positive half cycle, what we are observing, so this is positive, this is negative. So here this is positive, it means diode D1 is working, it will conduct, and diode D2 does not conduct. So finally, if it is conducting, then current I1 is passed. Current I1 we can get, and this current I1 is comes at the load terminal. So we can say that in the positive half cycle we get the 0 to pi, we get the current I1. Again, we can apply the negative half cycle. When we are applying the negative half cycle, in that case, we are observing that here this is the open loop, but this is the closed loop. So it means we got the I2 current. So in the second case, we got I2 current. So from pi to 2 pi, we got I2 current. Now, both will combine, then it will give the final current A from pi to 0 to pi and pi to 2 pi. This is our final current. So this is the working condition of full wave rectifiers. Next one, third one is we can talk about bridge rectifier. In the bridge rectifier, here it consists of four diodes. So now we are taking the step down transformer. Same, we are applying the 230 volt, 50 hertz frequency. This is the step down transformer. Now we have four diodes. So we have four diodes. Suppose we can consider D1, and this is D2, this is D3, and this is D4. Now again here we are applying here the load resistance. We need to find the output voltage or output current across the load. Now we are applying input voltage. So 0 to pi, pi to 2 pi. Now first of all, we apply here positive half cycle. So during the positive half cycle, now here, if it is positive half cycle, then current comes to here. Now here, what we are observing in that case, this is positive, this is negative. It means diode D1 and diode D2 are in forward bias, but diode D3, because of this is here, if the current will come, main current, it will divide in two sections. So this current is positive, this current is negative, so this is the open circuit. So whatever we current here sent, this all current comes to D1 and comes to here, then it will, here we are taking the load. So D2, the D1, across the D1, across the D2, both current reach at the load terminals. So during the positive half cycle, we observe that D1 and D2 are forward bias, D3 and D4 are reverse bias. So we got 0 to pi, same voltage, or according to voltage we get the currents. Similarly, when during the negative half cycle, in that case, now here the terminal is changed. Terminal is changed means, now here negative half cycle means this side. So in that case, this is positive. Now here this is positive. And here this is negative. This is positive. So when negative half cycle comes, in that case D3 and D2, both are negative-negative. So negative-negative means forward bias. So D3 and D4 conducts D1 and D2 open circuits. So in that case also, we observe that from pi to 2 pi, we get same potential. How many maximum voltage is? that voltages we got by the
applications of the
here